I'm Giacomo Andreoletti and I work at the School of Advanced Studies, University of Tumen. I do philosophy and I specialize in the philosophy of time and the philosophy of time travel. As a philosopher working on time, I often get questions about movies that feature time travel or temporal paradoxes in general. The latest time-related movie was Tenet by Christopher Nolan. Tenet was not only a big success at the box office, but it also generated public interest in the topic of time. That is why I decided to make this video to talk about time with you. In Tenet, one of the main themes is the phenomenon of time inversion. In the movie, characters move backward in time and ordinary objects such as bullets move backward in time too. Notice that this is different from standard cases of time travel, which we are familiar with thanks to many other science fiction movies. For in standard time travel stories, characters jump back to the past, but once they're back to the past, they start moving forward in time, as all of us do in our ordinary lives. In Tenet, however, the story is different. People and objects move backward in time while the rest of the universe goes forward. Is it possible? The short answer is no. None of the knowledge we have seems to suggest that the events depicted in Tenet are physically possible. That is, the laws of nature as we know them do not allow that we have objects moving backward in time while the rest of the universe goes forward. However, the very idea of time inversion is not too far-fetched. Actually, there is a sense according to which the time inversion of the whole universe is a possibility. Time has a direction. We live our lives coming from the past and moving toward the future. For instance, we remember things that happened in the past, but we do not remember things that will or might happen in the future. We deliberate about the future, but we do not make plans about what happened yesterday or 10 days ago. We see things in the past causing other things in the future. And we see ourselves and everything else aging as time goes by. Time seems to have a direction, from the past toward the future. What could be more obvious and more true than this? However, things are not as simple when it comes to time. Time is a mysterious phenomenon. We already know, thanks to the work of Albert Einstein in the past century, that our common sense, everyday understanding of time is just wrong. For instance, we now know that time passes at different velocities in different regions of the universe. And this is the case also on our planet Earth. Time, for instance, runs faster on the top of a mountain than it does at the sea level. Or, close to a black hole, time is so slow that it almost stops. Time contains many counterintuitive and puzzling aspects. The direction of time is just one of them. So, what is puzzling about time having a direction? The puzzle has to do with the fact that if we look at the candidates for laws of nature that the scientific community came up with throughout the centuries, and I'm thinking about stuff like Newtonian mechanics, Maxwell's equations, or quantum mechanics, all these laws of nature, they are time symmetric. What this means, roughly, is that the laws of nature do not make a distinction between the past and the future. That is, if you have a physical process that runs forward in time from a moment T0 to a moment T10, and it does so in accordance with the laws of nature, the same physical process run in reverse from the moment T10 to the moment T0 is still in accordance with the laws of nature. The laws of nature do not make a distinction between the two directions. You can have an example of the time symmetry of the laws of nature if you think about billiard balls bouncing around on a billiard table like we have here in the background. Suppose that you have two billiard balls, one moving from the left of the table toward the second one, which is initially stationary. When the first ball hits the second one will start moving thanks to the collision. Now, suppose that you film this very simple physical process. The idea here is that it does not matter whether you watch the clip that you just filmed forward or in reverse. They are both in accordance with the laws of nature. They will both seem natural to us. The first one obviously is, just because we filmed something which happened in reality, but so is the second one. In fact, in the second one, the one that runs in reverse, we would observe that the second billiard ball is coming from the right toward the first one And then the second one eats the first one, and finally the first one starts moving toward the left. This second take, the one in reverse, is still in accordance with the laws of nature, as was the first one. So, the laws of nature do not make a distinction between the past and the future. Given that the laws of nature describe how reality fundamentally is, some philosophers argue that fundamentally time does not have a direction. Intrinsically, time will be ordered but not directed. In philosophy, this is known as the C theory of time. Why the name C theory? Well, because there are other two theories of time, the A theory of time and the B theory of time. According to the A theory of time, time is dynamic. We should think of time as a succession of present moments. Right now, this moment is present.
But then reality changes and a new moment is present. The previous one is gone. In the A theory of time, time is something dynamic that moves and passes. This passage of time gives time its order and a direction as well, the direction from the past toward the future.
According to the B theory of time, on the other hand, time is static. We should think of all times and all events in time as equally existing. The present obviously exists, but so do the past and the future. In this picture, the universe is a big block of events encompassing all times. There is no dynamism in this picture, as time does not flow nor pass. However, there is a direction. According to the B theory, we should talk of events as being earlier or later than other events. For instance, World War I and World War II, they both exist according to the B theory, but one is earlier than the other one. According to the C theory of time, time does not move like it happens, for instance, in the A theory of time. And it does not have a direction either. We should not talk of events as being earlier or later than other events, as we do with the B theory of time, but only of events as being between other events. So, to conclude, we started by discussing the movie Tenet, and we said that the events depicted in the movie are not physically possible. We cannot have the time inversion of single objects while the rest of the universe goes forward. However, the time inversion of the whole universe is, for all we know, a possibility. After all, if the C theorists are right, both directions of time, forward and backward, are a possibility.